What's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Nail That Tone, a series that's all about helping you guys achieve some of the most legendary guitar tones of all time. In this week's episode, we're talking about Iron Maiden's Brave New World guitar tone, specifically about the song The Wicker Man. There's so many cool stuff to talk about, as always, so let's get right into it. As always with the Nail That Tone series, the first thing we're talking about is finger tone. So for this week's finger tone, I really want to highlight the importance of Adrian Smith and his comeback to the band during this era. I think the biggest thing to the sound and tone of this album is him coming back, joining the band, and kind of bringing back his guitar sound to this album. So again, his contribution to the band can't be understated. His guitar style, his guitar riffs really contribute to the sound of Iron Maiden on this particular record. So now we're talking about what gear was used on this particular record. Now the good thing is that there is an interview with Adrian Smith around this era where he rejoined the band, and he does specifically state that he was using an ADA MP1 preamp. However, when he rejoined the band, he found out that the other guys were using the Marshall JMP1 preamp. He went ahead and switched over to that preamp. So it's very likely that that's what we hear on this particular record, and it's what they were using live during this era of Iron Maiden. Of course, there's always a possibility that they use other Marshall amplifiers, and I think some of the more modern JCM series are some of the amps that we saw in their live rigs during this era. So it's certainly possible that they may have used one of these more modern amps or some of the classic JMPs that they were known for using. And when it comes to guitar cabinets, it's very likely going with the Marshall theme that they probably use some kind of Marshall 4x12 with probably some classic greenback speakers or V30s or T75s. Again, pretty common speakers that would have been found and just popular cabinets that were used all over by different players. When it comes to the guitars, we actually hear a lot more Adrian Smith because he actually wrote and recorded this particular track. So when it comes to guitars, it's kind of speculation here, but I would say that Adrian Smith probably used some kind of guitar with humbuckers, maybe Super Strat kind of body, because that's kind of the guitars that we see him play, and he's always kind of liked that body style of guitar. So now we're talking about the gear that I use to get the particular sound that you guys heard in the beginning of the video. Now, I'm a big fan of the XFX. I think it's a great unit, and it's great at replicating some classic tones, and there's so many different parameters that you can change that you can kind of shape your sound. So I'm definitely a big fan of using it, especially when I don't have the actual gear. So the first block we have is a noise gate just for some noise suppression. So we're using the JMP preamp for our amp type, and we have the overdrive 1 with the bass shift, and we have the input drive at around 9, so that's set pretty high. Bass is also pretty high at 6. Mids is a little bit lower, and treble being a little bit higher, with the presence being kind of at 50 or 6. And for cabs, a good thing is that we used some factory cabs, and for the future I would like to kind of just use factory cabs in general, so that I'm able to share the presets with you guys and you guys can use the same cabs that we use, so there's no confusion there or difference in sound, because some of the third-party IRs, you can't share those because it would be maybe a copyright thing. So we're using the factory 517 and the 522, and we always like to add EQ at the end of our signal chain because that kind of helps you do the final shaping for your tones. That's pretty much it for this preset, and I think that most good presets in the XFX should be pretty simple, where you have kind of an amp, a cab block, maybe some EQ blocks, and that's pretty much it. I think any kind of preset that's just too convoluted with too many things, I think it's not getting at the core of what the sound really is. It's really just a preamp with a good IR and just some EQ shaping. So that's pretty much it for the preset, and that's pretty much what we used and what you guys heard in the beginning of the video. So now we're talking about what other gear you could use to get a similar tone. I would recommend getting a JMP1 if you could find one and get one, because they are still relatively cheap and just a great sounding preamp. So I would definitely recommend getting one of those. And if you can't afford one of those, or you're looking for a cheaper option, I think any of the kind of budget Marshall amplifiers will get you pretty close, because the sound of Iron Maiden has always been that kind of classic Marshall mid-gain sound. So that's definitely what I would recommend. For guitars, I would recommend using any guitar with humbuckers in it, because that's going to give you that fullness that you're going to need for the rhythm tone for most metal music. And when it comes to guitar cabinets, I would recommend using any guitar cabinet that you like. Sounds good to you, I wouldn't worry too much about exactly what speaker or whatever. If it sounds good to you, I recommend using that. Anyway, guys, that's pretty much it for this video. If you like this video and learned something cool about this album or this particular song, go ahead, leave a like, comment, and consider subscribing. We release videos like these on a weekly basis, so hopefully, guys, we will see you in the next video.